Brittany Whipple, and this is my husband,
Brian Whipple.
We have been dating for
a little bit over, well, actually, we've been married for 6 months, and we've probably been dating for 10 years, 1 month, and 19 days.
You feel like summertime. You took this heart of mine.
That's how long we've been dating for real, or you made that up?
No, because we got married in September. We met July 14th. We got married September 30th.
Okay, it's okay.
July, August, September. If you count 14, 20, I mean 30, that's actually a month and like, month
so
and 16.
That's so sweet that you know
like,
that.
10 years, a month and 16 days. So.
My dog. I know that. So sweet.
Not trying to be, you know. Yeah, we are here to share our wedding experience.
I've been roaming around, always looking down, and all I see, painted faces fill the places I can't breathe.
Ooh, that's all I can do in this little dress. That's all I can do at the reception. Hey, because I cannot move this way.
I was doing a lot on that day, you know, from greeting to, you know, trying to keep my emotions in control.
You cried all day.
Well, I don't want to say cry all day, you know, but I was emotional. I can't even lie. My favorite moment was seeing you walk down the aisle. And only do I say that just because I feel every groom has to say this to where the entire time of us being together has just went through the whole 10 years. Just flashed before my eyes in a matter of what, maybe like 15, maybe 30 seconds.
Because I'm a daddy's girl, so I would say my first favorite moment is the first look with my dad. And my dad's a Marine, he is not an emotional person. So to see him cry, his baby girl dressed up like that was a very special moment for me. And then I'm gonna say the second one was coming down and seeing not only you, but seeing Jaden at the altar. That was a very surreal moment. It was like nobody else existed except y'all.
Yeah.
In that moment, and I was literally trying to hurry up and get down there. Like, almost tripped. That was not captured on video, but that is a behind the scenes thing that you didn't know. I almost tripped coming down the aisle.
You feel like summertime. You took this heart of mine. You'll be my Valentine in the summer. In the summer, you are my only one. Just dancing, having fun.
So what led us to choosing a videographer was speaking to previous brides, or of course, when you're getting married, you obsess over weddings. So you look at a lot of interviews, you look at a lot of wedding shows, and then you just kind of realize like, hey, the bride is like secluded. She only gets to see her girls and her family. Like she's literally held captive until she walks down the aisle. So for me, it's just like, man, like how am I gonna get to see all of these little moments, you know, if I'm secluded?
Yeah.
A photograph can capture, you know, what happened.
Still moments.
A still shot, yeah. A still moment.
Yeah.
But you're like, well, what happened after that? Or what was their emotion? Or what did they say?
Right.
Like, so with a video, all of those questions were answered. So it was just like, okay, we are a little tight on the budget, but this is a requirement. Like, it is necessary. We have to have a video,
right,
or our day is gonna go by super fast and there's gonna be so many dynamics that we miss.
Right. For me personally, and for us personally, like she just mentioned, like my wife just mentioned, this was a necessity. Just because for me personally, I'm someone that if I see a picture, just like she mentioned, if someone had a shocking face, or just for me personally, when I was crying, they wanna know exactly, okay, at what point in time was this man bawling his eyes out with no tissue in sight, you know?
Right.
So, and for me, and that, and like, or if, you know, when I, while I was crying, I noticed that my son was looking up at me. And of course, with my son, he is someone that's filled with so much personality. I wanted to see what his next reaction would be after he looked up at me like, Dad, why are you crying, you know? So, I mean, granted, when it comes to photographs, when it comes to videos, definitely cost should play a factor, but I don't feel as if you automatically take it off the table, because apps, I feel in the next 10 to 20 years, after we get done looking at our video, or sorry, our photos, we can definitely pull up that video and actually just sit back and just
relive the day.
You know, and that's where we are. I want to relive that day as much as possible. And I feel like with me pulling out a thumb drive or a disc and has given me that option to do so, I want to do it.
Maybe like 30 times.
You would say 5 times.
35. A little 10 cushion, maybe 45, but yeah. A lot. We watch it a lot.
Yeah.
A lot.
Yeah. It's the work. Because truth be told, you got to think about it. If the video that we received was horrible, we have no reason to watch it. But that just speaks volume
about the quality
and the work that has been provided to us that makes us want to watch it over and over. And that's exactly what it is. We seriously relive it every single time we watch it. So
we would definitely refer you to our not even just based on the quality, I think just based on like Dre and his team, like
they made us feel comfortable.
I felt like I was working with my cousin.
Right,
like, he was very comfortable, but it was not too comfortable where I felt like, okay, he's not being professional.
Right.
It was just like, I didn't feel pressured to do anything. I didn't feel like he was annoying me. Like, it was just a very smooth process. One of the young ladies that worked with him, Bree, fixed my dress, which she didn't have to do. That's not her job. She wasn't my assistant. But she noticed, okay, hey, this will look better in the shot, not only for videography, but photography purposes. So, hey, let me make sure that this bride is taken care of. And I feel like that's going above and beyond as far as customer service. So I would definitely, definitely, definitely recommend D2R.
Absolutely. Girl, I want to marry you.